Ciao everybody, Caterina here. Welcome to my home. Well, my home is Christmas and I love this time of year, especially for the baking. And today I'm going to be preparing a very special cookie by the name of Rosettes. This cookie was first introduced to me by my dear friend Boda in Norway. You are going to need a tool for this cookie and she did gift me one. I will show it to you. Really simple to prepare. Now let's get started. Today I'm going to show you how to prepare Norwegian rosettes. This is a tool you're going to need for this recipe and it's called a rosette maker. You can purchase these in any kitchenware store. We're going to start by preparing the batter. You can mix it by hand, but it takes so long. If you have a blender, just use your blender. 2 large eggs, tablespoon of granulated sugar, 1/4 teaspoon of kosher salt. I'm going to give this a quick blitz. Perfect. 1 cup of full fat milk. 1 tablespoon of purified water, and I'm going to give it another blitz. I'm going to add 1 teaspoon of vanilla bean extract. Bodhi's secret ingredient was rose water, 1 tablespoon of rose water. And I recall when I was there, she said, if you're out of rose water, stop what you're doing, get to the grocery store and buy it. Do not leave this ingredient out. And you'll know why, the fragrance is incredible. I'm going to give this a really good blitz. We'll need 1 cup of all-purpose flour and we're going to begin by adding 2 tablespoons at a time. I'm going to blitz. I'm just going to continue until I finish all the flour. Mixed beautifully, thoroughly. Now I'm going to transfer the batter to a glass bowl, a square one, where your tool will fit in. You'll see why. I'm just going to put the lid on top, a minimum of 6 hours. I'm going to go and get batter that I prepared yesterday. Here is 1 batter mix that I prepared 24 hours ago. I'm going to give it a really good mix. I like using my electric fryer for this. You need to heat up your rosette maker inside the fryer, so I'm going to place it in here now. Also, the temperature of the oil should be at 350 degrees Fahrenheit. I've already started making them and I'm going to say it, if you could only smell my kitchen. It's extremely important that you keep the iron in the oil at all times. It has to stay very hot or your cookies will not turn out. Now you're going to have to blot it with each cookie, so just lightly blot it so that the dough will adhere to the iron in there. Now this is very important. You cannot go over the iron. You can only go to the sides. If you go over the iron, the cookie will not dislodge in the oil. We're going to hold it for about 30 seconds. Another tip that is wonderful are wooden chopsticks for this job. Now that they've started to dislodge, the chopstick will help. I'm going to put the iron back into the oil and I'm just going to turn the rosette around and fry it on both sides. Look how beautiful and golden brown this is. Now I'm going to turn it over. Chopsticks also, it's very easy to remove them from the hot oil. Now, when you put it on your paper towel, make sure you put the hollow part at the bottom so that they don't become soggy. More time. Blot the iron in the dough, in the batter. Do not exceed the iron. And then in the oil. Couldn't be easier. Hold it for at least 20, 25 seconds. Once you notice that the batter is dislodging, you can pop it along with your chopsticks. And there you go. Now we're just going to allow it to brown. I'm going to leave the iron in the oil. Brown on one side, golden brown on the other. Now it's ready for me to remove it. Oh, I love this aroma on my paper towel. I finished one batch of rosettes. This batch I'm going to set aside and then I'm going to dredge them with icing sugar. The next batch of rosettes, I'm going to immediately after frying them, dunk them in granulated sugar and then set them aside to dry. I've started preparing my rosettes dunked in granulated sugar. Look how pretty. It's a totally different look altogether. They almost look frosted. I'm going to show you how I prepared these. Same concept. We're just going to fry the rosette. And I have granulated sugar here on the side. I'm just going to drain where the cavities are. And in the granulated sugar, I'm going to put the closed part down, rub it against the granulated sugar, and then with a spoon, I'm going to sprinkle all the little cavities of the rosette and turn it over. And how gorgeous is that? So there's two different ways of preparing your rosettes. One more time, just going to drain the back side in the sugar. Give it a little nudge. With a spoon, I'm just going to fill in the cavities of the rosette. And then I am going to rub over. And there we are. How pretty is that? Tell me that that is not pretty. The ones drenched in granulated sugar are done. We're just going to let them dry. And the other ones have reached room temperature. So we're going to dredge these ones with icing sugar. Look how gorgeous. I know they're called rosettes, but to me they look like huge snowflakes. There is a third option, but unfortunately I don't have time to prepare those because we're off to a Christmas party and I'm late and I have to get dressed. Third option is to drizzle the rosettes with honey and crushed walnuts. I'll be preparing those tomorrow. These rosettes freeze beautifully in your freezer for up to 2 months. Now, I will be freezing half of them for Christmas morning, and I'm going to show you how I'm going to do this. I'm going to place the rosettes in a paper plate, perhaps four at a time, like this, and then in a freezer bag, like this. I'm going to close the freezer bag securely. And in the freezer they go. When you take them out of the freezer, put them on a tray, heat them up at 350 for a couple of minutes, redredge them with icing sugar, and you would know that they were not fresh. I'm so pleased the way my Norwegian rosettes turned out. I'm going to taste one for you. You know, I have to confess I've already eaten four, but I think I'm going to do the one with the ice. I'm going to taste the one with the icing sugar. Tastes like Christmas. You really must try this wonderful recipe. I want to thank you so much for joining me today. And it's Katerina from my home to yours. I would like to take this opportunity to wish you all a very Merry Christmas to you and all your families. Don't forget to hit your like button, and if you haven't already done so, subscribe to my channel and share my recipes. Ciao! Oh yeah, candles burning low, lots of mistletoe, lots of snow and ice, everywhere we go. Christmas means to me, my love. Oh, yeah.
before. Even though I love you madly, it seems I love you more.